Hello students, here in today's video we are going to solve some of the MCQs related to the chapter solutions. After completing the chapters, you might have recalled with the formulas. But now we'll be using some shortcut tricks to solve the questions. Now here is some of the questions. See the first one, the vapor pressure of a solution containing 2 moles of a solute. So here they have given the moles of the solute in 2 moles of water. So if I see this, number of moles of solute is 2, number of moles of solvent is also 2, and therefore total number of moles is 4. Now here itself, how to use the trick to solve the question? So I am showing that, student. You know from the formula that relative lowering of vapor pressure, that is the vapor pressure of the pure component minus that of the solution upon vapor pressure of the pure component, is equal to the mole fraction of the solute. Now if you see this question, here we have calculated the total number of moles, that is 4. Therefore, what will be the mole fraction of the solute will be equal to number of moles of the solute, that is 2, divided by total number of moles, that is 4. So this will become half or 0.5. So after substituting in this equation, it will be P minus of P upon vapor pressure of the pure solvent is equal to 0.5. If you read the question, vapor pressure of pure water is given, that is 24 mm of Hg. So if I substitute here, it will be 24 minus P upon 24 is equal to 0.5. That means 24 minus P is equal to 0.5 into 24. So 24 minus P is equal to 12, and so P is equal to 12. So your answer here is 12 mm of Hg. Now students, if you see the question and you know the concept of vapor pressure, if I take a pure solvent in a container and I say the pure vapor pressure of the solvent is, say, x mm of Hg, and if I add a solute to it to make a solution, then what will be the vapor pressure of the solution, student? Vapor pressure of the solution must be less than x. Means because there is always lowering of vapor pressure. That means the vapor pressure of the solution must be less than the vapor pressure of the pure solvent. Now if you see this question, vapor pressure of pure water is 24 and we have added a solute. Whatever is the mole, the vapor pressure of the resulting solution must be less than 24. And if I check the options, the less than value of 24 is only 12. So here the answer is 12. This way it is confirmed. Come on to the next question. The colligative property of a solution is, now when we talk about colligative properties, we have 4 colligative properties: lowering of vapor pressure, elevation in boiling point, depression in freezing point of the solvent, and osmotic pressure. So if I check out which colligative property is given here, according to that, osmotic pressure is a colligative property. Students, vapor pressure, boiling point, osmosis, freezing point, they are not colligative properties. So here they are asking about colligative property. So your answer is osmotic pressure. Move on to the next one. In calculating osmotic pressure, the concentration of solute is expressed in. Now let us know first what is the formula to calculate osmotic pressure. So osmotic pressure pi is equal to CRT. And if I see what is C, is the concentration, which is equal to N by V. Now what is N by V, student? Is the number of moles per unit volume. So it is mole per dm cube or mole per liter. And what is mole per dm cube or mole per liter? Is molarity. So what will be the answer here for question number 3? Is molarity. That is your first option. Ebullioscopic constant is the boiling point elevation when the concentration of solution is. Students, ebullioscopic constant, if I see, What is the equation for ebullioscopic constant? Let us see that. You know that elevation in boiling point is directly proportional to molality through experimental studies. Or delta TB is equal to KB into M. So this is what is the ebullioscopic constant. Now, when this elevation in boiling point will be equal to the ebullioscopic constant, when this molality is equal to 1. If I make this molality 1, then I can say that elevation in boiling point is equal to ebullioscopic constant. So when this will be equal to this, when the solution is of 1 molal. So what is the answer here is 1 molal. See the next one. Cryoscopic constant depends on. Cryoscopic constant is a characteristic of any solvent, and so it always depends upon the nature of the solvent. And therefore, student, while doing the calculations, you must know the cryoscopic constant for water is always 1.86 kkg mole inverse. So this is a fixed characteristic of any solvent. Like cryoscopic constant, ebullioscopic constant is also the characteristic of any solvent, and therefore this ebullioscopic constant of water is also fixed, that is 0.52 kkg mole inverse. Whatever is the concentration, those values, they remain same. And those values will only and only change when the nature of the solvent will change. When the solvent is changed, then only the values will change. And therefore, the cryoscopic constant depends only and only on the nature of the solvent. Come to the next one. Identify the correct statement. You have to find out a correct statement out of this. They are talking something about the vapor pressure, boiling point, osmotic pressure. So they are talking about the colligative properties. Now here, as the options goes, I will take the first three colligative properties and let us see what the changes are. For that, I have taken the pure solvent. And I will see the vapor pressure. Say the vapor pressure here is X. When I add a solute to it to make a solution, then the vapor pressure of the solution will be less because there is always lowering of vapor pressure. So this is the first one. Come to the second one. If I have taken a solvent and its boiling point, that is T of the pure solvent, say is X, and when I add a solute to it, what happens to the boiling point, student? Boiling point will increase. The third colligative property is osmotic pressure. So if I take a pure solvent and its vapor pressure is, osmotic pressure is X, then for the same type of the solution, osmotic pressure will increase. So out of those, let us come to the last one. As we have seen for colligative properties, as I said, osmosis is not a colligative property. So here they want a correct statement. So this is a wrong statement. Now the above three, let us find out which is correct. If I say this, means the vapor pressure of the pure solvent is always more than that of the solution. Here they have written vapor pressure of solution is higher than that of the pure solvent. So the first statement is wrong. Come to the second one. Boiling point of the solvent is lower than, if you see this option, boiling point of the solution is higher than that of the pure solvent. So if I see the second option, boiling point of a solvent is lower than that of its solution. So this is a correct option. So here your answer is second option. Let us move on to the next question. A living cell contains a solution which is isotonic. What is the meaning of isotonic, students? Isotonic means, iso means same. Tonic is the concentration. So you can say two solutions or more than two solutions having the same concentration. And if they have same concentration, they must have same osmotic pressure also. So let us go through the question. First, they are talk the first solution what they are talking about is 0.3 molar sugar solution. Now, when I talk about sugar solution, its Wantoff factor, that is N dash value, is 1 because it's a covalent molecule. Now, if I continue the question, what they do is, what osmotic pressure develops when the cell is placed in 0.1 molar. So, the second solution is 0.1 molar. KCl solution. If you see KCl by nature is an ionic compound and therefore it will dissociate to give me K plus and Cl minus ions, and therefore its Wantoff factor is 2. It's double that of sugar. Now what the question is, that what will be the osmotic pressure developed at body temperature? Students, body temperature, usually we take this body temperature as 37 degrees Celsius. Actually, body temperature is between 36.5 to 37.5, but for calculations, body temperature, we consider it as 37. Now, if you see the temperature here, they have given the body temperature. So, I will first convert this to Kelvin. So, it will be 273 plus 37. So, it will come out to 310 Kelvin. No need to take 0.15 for MCQ calculations. So, the temperature what I get here is 310. Now, they are talking about the two solutions. So, what will be the osmotic pressure, students? So, the total osmotic pressure is equal to, simple formula what you have to use. First, I will take the initial solution. Which is the initial solution, student? They have taken the sugar solution as the initial. So, it will be initial minus the final solution concentration. So, what will be the initial one? The Wantoff factor of the first solution, concentration of the first solution, RT. From where I got this, student? This is from pi is equal to CRT. First, I will take for sugar and then I will take for KCl. So, for sugar, I am marking 1 and for KCl, I am marking 2. So, it will be minus I2C2 and RT, you know, it's constant. So, this is equal to IC1 minus IC2 and RT, I will take it as common out. So, what is the Wantoff factor for sugar solution? What we have calculated, the Wantoff factor is 1. So, it will be 1 into, what is the concentration given here, student? Is 0.3. So, this is 0.3 minus 2 into 0.1. If you see, the Wantoff factor for KCl is 2. And what is its concentration? 0.1. So, this into RT. Let us solve this. This will become 0.3 minus 2 into 0.1 is 0.2 into RT. So, this difference will come to 0.1 into 0.082. Now, why I took this as 0.082? You know that, student, if I see the options here, the options, they are all given in ATM. And so, I will use the value of R in liter atmosphere, mole inverse, Kelvin inverse, which is 0.082, and multiply this by 310. Now, when you solve this question, 0.1 into 0.082 into 310, so your answer is 2.54 ATM. So, your answer is 2.54 ATM. So, answer here is second option. Come to the next one. Now, the question is, the osmotic pressure of blood is 7.65 atm at 310 Kelvin. An aqueous solution of glucose is isotonic with blood has the percentage. Now, here they are asking about percent by volume. What is the meaning of percent, student? Is 100. And any solution, when we talk about the standard solution, it is always in 1 liter or 1000 ml. So, let us see what is this question about. So, here, if I see the first one, what I have to do is, the osmotic pressure is given. So, let us write what all things are given. So, osmotic pressure is given, that is 7.65 atm. Next, they have given the temperature, that is 310. So, which formula we will use, student, is pi is equal to CRT. Through this, I will get the concentration from here. So, let us do this. So, pi is given. So, I will directly go for this concentration. So, I am rearranging the equation. C is equal to pi by RT. So, pi value is 7.65 divided by 0.082 into 310. So if I do this calculation, I will get 0.3009. Now students, when you do this type of calculations, you can roughly take this as 300 for the calculation. You get the nearby values. So how I can do this? So let us see the rough calculation what you can use here. So this will become 765 divided by this two places to this side and two places to this side. So this will become 8.2 into 310. So if I divide this nearly by 765 by 8 and into 300. So rough calculations will help me now. So this, if I cancel this, it will give me 9.5 divided by 300. So this will come nearly to 300 something like this. So this will be 0 point. So I get the nearby values. So first I got the concentration. So concentration is 0.3009. Now students, this concentration is what student is N by V. So constant, I will write here N by V is equal to 0.3009. Now how much is the volume? Volume is 1000 ml. So let us go by the easier way now. Means this is number of moles. What is number of moles is equal to is mass or given mass upon molar mass. Now so here which solute they are using here student is glucose. And what is glucose? Glucose is C6H12O6 whose molar mass is 180 gram. So let us substitute here. So this will be 0.3009 is equal to, let us call this as W. So W upon molar mass is 180 gram. So what is the mass? That is 180 into 0.3009. So simply you can multiply this by 3. So how much this will come to? Nearly 54 point. So I am giving the answer here. It will come to 162. Nearly 54 will also help you to go to the nearby option. Now this much is present in 1000 ml. Now as they are asking for 100 ml. So for 100 ml it will be how much? If I see this to this change, from 1000 to get 100, I have to divide this by 10. So I will divide this also by 10. So your answer is 5.416. So student, what is the answer? Answer is the first option. Come to the next one. Vapor pressure of a solution. Now vapor pressure of a solution is directly proportional to the mole fraction of solvent. Now this is what vapor pressure is directly proportional to the mole fraction of the solvent. So for solutions containing non-volatile solutes, Raoult's law may be stated as at a given temperature, the vapor pressure of a solution containing non-volatile solutes is directly proportional to the mole fraction of the solvent. So this is through Raoult's law. So let us see for the option directly proportional to, so this is solute, so this is wrong, directly proportional to the mole fraction of the solvent. So this is which law is followed here student, is Raoult's law for a non-volatile component. So here the answer is fourth option. Let us come to the next one. Pressure cooker reduces cooking time for food because, this is very easy student, because the boiling point of water inside the pressure cooker is increased and therefore the cooking time is reduced and food gets cooked very faster. Let us move on to the next question. That is related to Henry's law. Henry's law constant for a gas, that is methyl bromide, is given. So what is this student? This is Henry's constant, that is K or KH at 250 degrees Celsius. What is the solubility? Means they are asking about S. What is the solubility? And a partial pressure is also given, that is this. So let us see what is the formula student. Formula for Henry's constant or Henry's law. What is the formula, student? that K is or S solubility is directly proportional to the pressure applied. So solubility is equal to Henry's constant into pressure. Now in the question, they are asking you to calculate Henry's constant is given. They are asking you to calculate solubility. So solubility is equal to Henry's constant, that is 0.159 into partial pressure, 164. So this is, after doing this, what you get is 0.026076. So molar. So this is what the answer is. So according to that, your answer is third option. Now, students, if you see the values here, solubility is equal to, this value is 0.159 into 0.164. If I remove the decimals here in this way, this will become 10 raised to minus 6. So, excluding the decimals, if I see this, this is nearly 16 and this is 16. So your answer must be near to 256, 260. So if I see the options here, option only with 250 and 260 range is this. So this is how you can reach to the nearby options. Because if I see this, this is 159, means nearly it is 16. I can make this. If I shift two decimals to this place and two decimals to this place, this gives me 16. And 16 square comes to this range only. So your answer is third option. Come to this question now. Which of the following statement is not correct for 0.1 molar urea solution and 0.05 molar sucrose solution? Now, students, if you see the concentration and the name of the solute, what they have given. Here they have given urea, which is 0.1 molar. And the second solution is sucrose, which is 0.05 molar. If I try to see the Wantoff factor, for both Wantoff factor is same. Now let us go through the options. Osmotic pressure exhibited by urea is higher than that exhibited by sucrose solution. Osmotic pressure will be directly proportional to concentration. Means more the concentration, more will be the osmotic pressure. Now, if I say this Wantoff factor is same, I can directly focus on the concentrations. So, concentration, if I check, urea is having a higher concentration and so osmotic pressure of urea must be more. So, osmotic pressure exhibited by urea is higher than that exhibited by sucrose solution is a correct statement. But we have to select a non-correct statement. So, let us move on to the second option. Urea solution is hypertonic solution. What is the meaning of hyper? Means having more osmotic pressure. So, urea solution will have more osmotic pressure as compared to the sucrose solution. So, your answer here, if I see, this is also correct. We want a wrong statement, student. So, this option given is also correct. Let us move on to the fourth option. Sucrose solution is urea solution. Hypotonic means having less osmotic pressure. So, if I see this, sucrose will have a less osmotic pressure because its concentration is less. So, this is also a correct statement. Now, what is left? They are isotonic solutions. Iso means they are having same osmotic pressure. Are they having the same osmotic pressure? No, because their concentrations are different. So, this is a wrong statement and you have to select a wrong statement. So, your answer is third option. I hope you understood the tricks and the ways of calculating. So if you like my video, please share it with your friends and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Students, if you want more similar and other types of MCQ questions, then please write in the comment box so that I can make some new videos for you all with different shortcuts. Thank you, students.